At the bottom of my garden, I built a garden shed. There I keep a poet, I think he's quite well read. So when it comes to writing songs, all I have to do is go down to my potting shed to obtain a line or two. He may not be Will Shakespeare, Lord Byron or a Keats, but his words are full of wisdom every time he speaks. When short of inspiration, when there's nothing in my head, it's time for me to seek help from the poet in my shed. He's there for consultation, morning, noon and night. You can email or tweet him for something erudite. If you need a helping hand or the mind is just a fog, it's time to post a message upon his website blog. Songwriters seek assistance when stuck from time to time. He's there to give a phrase or two or words that need to rhyme. Tom Paxton called some years ago when words were hard to find. My poet helped complete the words to last thing on my mind. Bob Dylan's verse is well renowned, his songs are so well known, but even Bob would tell you all the words are not his own. When stuck with blowing in the wind, no thoughts came to his head, Bob found the words from you know who, the poet in my shed. When it comes to pop song lyrics, no one does it better. John and Paul got help from him to finish Sergeant Pepper. He gave a line for Bye Bye Love to brothers Phil and Don, and also helped on Rocket Man for dear old Elton John. Lloyd Webber is the master of music on the stage. Take Phantom and Evita, his shows are all the rage. But when Tim Rice gets stuck for words, he had to turn instead to he who's always there to help, the poet in my shed. So next time you hear a lyric and think the words sound fine, it may not be the writer who made up every line. He might have sought a little help, could be some words were fed from the finest wordsmith of them all, the poet in my shed.